man clothes and line I design. Ain't thinking about the day 10 years, you'll see what a young find is. The G5, G6 classified, I done hit the bullseye. When you spread the rumors, make sure you tell them I'm multi. Millionaire, ain't playing foul, turn your back on any care. Cause I can wake up in it and travel anywhere.
Ready to rock. All right, so tonight's dumbbell and a HIIT workout. So fellas, you got 15s, ladies, you got 10s. Of course, adjust those weights up or down if you need to, but I think this is going to be a good workout to do with 10 pounders. All right, so let's stretch out, and while we're stretching out, I'll explain the workout. Feet together, go down, touch your toes. So you're also going to need a mat for tonight's workout. So if you don't have those dumbbells and the mats, you want to go grab those really quick. Come back to the workout. We'll still be here. Tonight's workout's going to be around 45 minutes. Big lunge over to your right side. Tonight's dumbbell and HIIT workout is designed around strength and then building your endurance, getting those heart rates up. We try to keep HIIT rounds around 40 seconds, no longer than 45 seconds if we're trying to do those high intensity interval rounds. Switch that lunge up. What's up, everybody? If you're tuning in, make sure you swipe over, hit that thumbs up button. Make sure we know where you're tuning in from, where you're working out with us from. Squat it down, take those hands to the heels, of course. All right, all major body parts on the stretch. When we get into the workout, pretty simple formula, all right? Pretty simple formula. We've got 8 different exercises. Each round is going to be 40 seconds long, all right? 40 seconds long. Switch that, or take that right heel, put that toe up, pull it all the way up. So each exercise you're going to do for 40 seconds. The first 20 seconds of the 40-second round is going to just be the dumbbell movement. The remaining 20 seconds, which is going to be your halfway mark through, you're going to hear the word mark. You're going to hear that on the timer, and that's when we add the HIIT movement, all right? Switch that heel up, opposite heel, point that toe up. So for the first 20 seconds, you're doing just the dumbbell movement. The remaining 20 seconds, you're doing the dumbbell movement plus the HIIT movement, all right? So it's dumbbell plus HIIT, all right? We combine those two together. Once the 40-second round is up, you're going to get 20 seconds off to rest, and then we go into the second move, all right? Same formula, 20 seconds for the dumbbell move, 20 seconds to add the movement to the HIIT move, all right? Then you go on to move 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. That would be considered one whole round, all right? So all 8 movements will be considered one round. We're going to do these 3 times, all right? So they're going to be 3 rounds. You're going to do moves 1 through 8 once, moves 1 through 8 twice, moves 1 through 8 for the third time, all right? Circle out those arms. Each movement, we're gonna walk you through. If you've done HIIT workouts with us before, you know they come pretty fast. But of course, we make sure, I'm here to make sure we're monitoring, even virtually, how your form is gonna be. And if it's a simple move that we just want you to do functionally, we're gonna walk you through those movements and we're gonna just let you go. We're gonna make sure you are focused on the important parts, engaging the core, your major muscle parts. But for the most part, unless it's a technical move, like a squat, we're gonna say keep your chest up, drop your butt, okay, bend your knees, stuff like that, but we're gonna rock and roll, all right? Take that right arm across the chest, and in each move, I'll preview the move going into the next move. So at the end of move one, I'll preview move number two. You're gonna get 20 seconds off. That's when you grab water, hydrate, and get ready for that next move. Take that opposite arm across the chest. Your first move, 20 seconds for the move with the dumbbell. The remaining 20 seconds, you're going to add the HIIT move, all right? So we're actually gonna go through an example and a demo so you can see and hear how it functions, and then we'll get into the actual workout, all right? Last couple stretches, circle out those necks. If you haven't, hit that thumbs up button. Make sure you hit that thumbs up button. If you're using that Apple Watch, you're on mixed cardio, all right? You can go to high intensity interval training if you want. Totally up to you. If you need to adjust the weights throughout the workout, adjust them up or down. And at any point, just go to body weight. Totally eliminate the dumbbells. Go straight to body weight. Don't even use any weight. All right? Take that right arm, tuck it behind the back. 8 movements, 40 seconds per round, or 40 seconds per move, all right, per exercise. And you're going to go through all 8 3 times. All right? So by the time you get to that third round, you've now learned the move because you've executed it for 2 previous rounds, of course. And then now you are fully acclimated with the weight, the functionality of the movement, the intensity that you need for the 40 seconds. You want to go all out for the 40 seconds. But of course, pace yourself based upon your fitness level. All right? We're ready to rock. Circle it up in studio. We are ready to rock and roll. We're going to jump right into it. The first movement, you're going to have both dumbbells on the opposite side of each leg, and you're just gonna do a dumbbell squat, all right? That's your simple move for the first 20 seconds. When you hear the word mark, all right, so let's go through a demo. Let's do a regular squat. No weights, just a demo. Here we go, 4, 3, 2, and squat. Just regular squat, up and down. Now, when you hear the word mark, you now add a jump. So you squat, then jump, then squat, then jump, all right? So let's go through the demo one more time. Act like this is the top of the round. 3, 2, 1, and squat. Regular squat. 20 seconds is gonna go by. You're gonna hear the word mark. At the word mark, you now add your plyometric jump, makes it a HIIT movement. So you go from the squat into the jump. So you execute the squat, stand up, jump. Land back soft, go into the squat, stand up, and jump. That's 40 seconds. First 20 seconds, just gonna be the dumbbell squat. The remaining 20 seconds is going to be the jump. I'm gonna talk to them off camera for just a second, and I wanna talk to you online. If you understand that, give me some thumbs up. We'll be right back in 60 seconds. All right, talk to me online. Let me know if you got it. I don't wanna leave you behind before we move on, because once we get going, we're gonna be rock and roll. All right, we're ready to rock. Thank you, Tawana, Renee, Marsha, Christine. One thing I do want to say before we get going, there are some movements that involve the right side only, all right? So there is a dumbbell swing that involves just the right side only. When we go to that round, 1 minute or 20 seconds, the entire round is designated to that right side, right? So when we do the dumbbell swing, you'll see me introduce that in just about 40 seconds after you take the first 40 seconds on the first move. I'll introduce that on the back end. All right, we are ready to rock and roll. Yes, sir, yes. All right, what you put into the workouts, what you get out of it. It's not about what I give you, it's about what you give the workout. You're going to hear that marker say 3, 2, 1, and you're going to go through 2, 1 dumbbell squats, 20 seconds. When you hear the word mark, you automatically add the plyometric hip move. So you're not waiting for me to cue you. You're going to hear the word mark in just 9 seconds.
Mark.
That cues you to add the jump. 15 seconds. 10 more seconds. We're almost through exercise number one.
Three, two, one.
All right. Rest. Now you got 20 seconds. Your second move is a dumbbell swing for the first 20 seconds. The remaining 20 seconds, you add a lunge back. First 20 seconds, right arm swing. Remaining 20 seconds, you're adding that back lunge, and we're live. First 20 seconds is just a dumbbell swing. When you hear the word mark, you automatically add a back lunge with the front swing. They happen at the same time. You're adding that hip step back move.
Mark.
And there's your mark. We got 10 seconds remaining in this move. And then we switch over to the left side coming off the break. So 3, 2, 1, take the break.
One,
all right, when
rest.
We come back, we're just switching over to the opposite arm, all right? First 20 seconds, left arm dumbbell swing. Remaining 20 seconds, we add the step back lunge in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And we're live.
Go.
Good. Feet are together. Yep. Dumbbell swing. Feet are level together. At the word mark, we step back, opposite leg. All right. 5 seconds. Keep a nice level base.
Mark.
We add that plyometric step back lunge with that dumbbell swing. Now the next move, we're going down to the ground, coming off the break. 3 seconds.
Three, two, one.
All right, we're going to core.
Rest.
Your first 20 seconds are going to be a regular dumbbell setup. When we add the plyo, it's in, out. Sit up, in, out. First 20 seconds, regular sit up.
Two, one.
And go. First 20, just your dumbbell sit up. Press it all the way straight up in the air. For 20 seconds. When you hear mark, knees go in out, then you do the full sit up in just 3 seconds.
Mark.
All right, in out on the knees, then the full sit up. Good. 15 seconds. You got 10 more seconds. We're already moving on to move. Next move, number 4. In 5 seconds.
Three, two, one.
All right.
Rest.
Single arm shoulder presses. Right, left. When we get to the 20 seconds, we add 3 pulses. 1, 2, 3. Then we're back to 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1.
Go.
First 20 seconds, alternating shoulder presses. When you hear the word mark, you add 3 pulses, and then you're back to the alternating presses and 3 pulses. Just 5 seconds. 4 seconds.
Mark.
Good. We add 3 pulses, and then you're back to your alternating presses, 3 pulses. You only got 10 more seconds. Then we're dropping down to mountain climbers. And we're adding plank jacks at the 20-second mark.
Rest.
All right, so we're running those knees into the chest for 20. At the marker, 1, 2, 3. One, two, three, four, five, six. And then three plank jacks. Six
three,
climbers
two,
to three
one,
plank jacks
go.
At the 20-second marker. Let's go. First 20, we're running those knees into that chest at the 20-second marker. You go right into three plank jacks and then count out six of those mountain climbers.
Mark.
Go. Three plank jacks. You go right at the mark. So right when you hear 20, you go right to the plank jacks for three. Then six climbers. Let's go. 5 seconds. Right at the mark.
Three,
two, one. All right, move six. We've got dumbbell down ups. Right side only for 20 seconds. We're adding a jump at the 20-second marker. All right, straight forward.
Three,
two, one. Right side only. 20 seconds on the down up. When you hear the word mark, we add the jump. We're staying on the right side all 40 seconds. As soon as you hear the word mark, you add the jump. 5 seconds. Four, three, two, one. Add the jump. Good. Let's go. Pick the pace up. Let's go. 15 seconds. Next round. Next side, we switch to the opposite arm. So if you started left, you go right. If you started right,
three,
you go left.
Two,
one. So you got 20
rest.
Seconds to switch from the right to the left or the left to the right. First 20 seconds, down up, no jump. Remaining 20 seconds, you add the jump. Here we go. 5 seconds, four, three, two, one, and we're live. No jump on the first 20.
Go.
If you have physical limitations, when we switch to the jump, don't do the jump. Keep your weighted down up. You got about 8 more seconds. At the mark, you add the jump. You got it already. 3 seconds. 3, 2, 1. We add the jump. Let's go. 15 seconds. Now, we're moving into a push-up and a walkout for move exercise number 7. 3, 2, 1. Perfect.
Rest.
All right, exercise number 7. Regular push-ups for the first 20. The remaining 20, we do the push-up. Walk out. Jump up. Do your push-up. Walk out. Jump up. 3, 2, 1. First 20, regular push-ups. All right? Then you walk the fingertips to the feet. Fingertips to the feet, and then you jump up. All right? 5 seconds. Walk the fingertips back to the feet. Jump up. Walk back out. Do your push-ups. Good. 15 seconds. Do the walk out. Do your push-up. Fingertips to the feet. Do the jump. Walk out. Perfect. 5 more seconds remaining.
3, 2, 1.
Perfect.
Rest.
Final move. Number 8. Regular curls. 20 seconds. Second 20. One set of curls. Half burpee. Dumbbells. Curls. First 20. Just curls. Remaining 20. Curls plus the half burpee. This is move number 8. Exercise number 8. End of this round. We do it all over again for a second round, all right? And then we're going to pick our pace up, all right? So look at this first round as your introductory round. Here we go. There's your marker. You go right to the burpee. So remember, when you hear the word mark, you go straight to the second half move. Nothing to think about. You go right into the second half move. 5 seconds.
3, 2, 1.
One, rest.
Done.
All right, grab water. You got an entire minute and 30 seconds off. Any questions in virtual land? Get it, 10 seconds. Move number one, dumbbell squats. We add intensity to the second round in three, two, one, and go. Let's go. First round, first part of the exercise, you've got just the dumbbell squat. When you hear the word mark, you add the jump. All right, 5 more seconds. We do a lot of grounding and pounding on the knees and the joints. You gotta have days where you get off that step and you go into a movement or a workout that's not as impactful on the joints and the knees. As much as we love to jump, run, hit that step, we gotta give those joints days to rest. Now movement number two. You know that you're going into the dumbbell swing. Now, your intensity is gonna be important throughout this entire workout. You have to gauge your intensity. If you feel like your heart rate is too high, slow down. If you feel like your heart rate's too low, pick up the pace a little bit. That's why we're using 10s, right in the middle of 8s and 15s, where you can still control the movement with decent intensity. One and go. Dumbbell swings for round, move number two, right? We're in round number two. You hear me say round number two. It's exercise two. We're in the second round, all right? In just 5 seconds, we're adding the lunge back. As soon as you hear the word mark, you lunge, you lunge, you lunge. You lunge and swing, good. As soon as you hear the word mark, you lunge and swing, good. Now you've only got 10 more seconds. Way to kick it in gear, Marshall. Way to push. I see you, Emily. End of this round, you switch arms to the from the right to the left. You relax for 20 seconds.
Rest.
And you focus square on getting ready to do those dumbbell swings for 20 seconds. When you hear the word mark, you automatically go back to the lunge. Now, the high intensity interval part is about your intensity and your level of the impact that you put into it. Your energy level, right? Not your impact jumping, but how impactful you are in the energy you put in. So if we're talking about high intensity interval, it can be low impact. It's a low impact move, but our intensity can make us sweat a little bit harder. That's why you see me in long sleeves. I want to sweat it out. 5 more seconds remaining. No judgment on anybody that wears short sleeves. 3, 2, 1. You add the lunge. You go. Now, your intensity goes up. It's a high intensity interval set of 20 seconds. All right? You're making sure when you step back, knee stays behind the toe. 3, 2, 1. All right.
Rest.
We've got those dumbbell sit-ups. Now, let's make sure we got it correct. We do the full sit-up. At the 20-second mark, we just go in, out. Sit up. In, out. Sit up. All right. 5 seconds.
Three.
First 20.
Two,
where are we at?
One.
Full dumbbell
go.
Sit up. And we're hauling ass. Let's go. We're trying to break those personal records. We're trying to push those limits, Emily. We're trying to get there. At that mark, we do the, we add the in and out.
Mark.
In and out. Then we do the sit up. And then we do the in and out. That's right. For 20 seconds. Now, next exercise, alternating dumbbell presses. 5 more seconds. 3, 2, 1. Jump up. Get ready for those shoulder presses. You alternate the press for the first 20. As soon as you hear the word mark, it's pulse, pulse, pulse. We fight to get back up to alternate the shoulder press. And then the 3 pulses. And then we get back up. All right. 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. We're setting up at the 3, 2, 1. We're working at the go. All right. That's important. So you're setting up when you hear 3, 2, 1. You're going when you hear go. So we're not going go, and then we're swinging to set up. We're setting up on the 3, 2, 1, then we go. So we maximize our time. There's your mark. You got 3 pulses, then you alternate the press. Exercise number 5, our climbers and plank jacks. At the 20-second marker, you go 3 plank jacks to 6 mountain climbers. 2, 1. We're down for exercise number 5. All climbers, and they've got to be floor sprints. They got to be floor sprints. 5, 4, 3, 2, you're running, you're sprinting. Climbers are a military workout called floor sprints that we've coined the term mountain climbers, but they're called floor sprints because you're sprinting on the floor. Come on, come on, dig those knees through the chest. When you hear the word mark, you automatically go into 3 plank jacks, Marsha, 3 Christine, and then you go into 6 climbers. Now, 3 plank jacks, 1, 2, 3, 6 climbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 3 plank jacks, 6 climbers. Come on there, dumbbell, high intensity workout, best of both worlds. You got 5 seconds, don't stop till you hear 2, 1, there's your break. Now we're up for dumbbell down ups. Now the second round. We've done this one round, so we know we're here now. All right, we're setting up now. We're setting up now so we can go on the 2, 1, go.
Go.
Now at the 20-second mark, what are we doing? And we're still digging through. You've got 12 seconds remaining. 8 more seconds till you hear the word mark and you add the jump.
Mark.
And there's your mark. Let's go. You gotta add the jump. Tap and go. Next exercise is gonna just switch to your left. All right? Come on, 8 seconds. Come on, push. Come on, We're going 3, for those personal records. 2, 1. We switch to the left arm and we get ready and we get set. Same exercise, different arm. Same intensity for 20 seconds. We add, if you can, the plyometric jump for the remaining 20 seconds. If you can't add it because you've got bad knees or joints, don't add the jump. Keep the dumbbell down up. We didn't create this movement, but we're creating the vibe. It's a down, up. Pretty simple movement, but structurally challenges your entire body. In 5 seconds, we add the jump. There's the jump. Come on, you got to dig to get through, to fight through to get back up. Come on. 15 seconds. I'd be lying to you if I didn't tell you that this workout was tough. 3, 2, 1. We rest. We got the push-ups to the walk-ups. All right? In just 10 seconds. And we're hauling ass on the push-up.
3, 2, 1.
We're engaged on the push-up. If you're on the knee, you're pushing. Legs are up. Chest, core, thighs is what hits the ground. If you're full non-mods, we're still getting off that ground, tapping the chest, core, thighs to the ground. At the word mark, we add the what? The walkout. The jump. Then we walk out. Attack the push-up to the earth, to the ground. And then we do the walkout. Come on, you got it. Move number 8, exercise number 8. We do the dumbbell curl and the half burpee.
3.
That'll be 2 rounds
rest
of all 8 movements. Good job. Come on, let's go. Come on, take our intensity up. We end this round. Now, curls. And what are we doing? We're still hauling ass. When you hear the half marker, you just had add the half burpee. Let's go. Come on, use 10s. Our moderate weight to use. But we have done these at 20s or 25s, of course. But with a higher frequency and going higher into rounds, we wanted to use a weight that would still challenge us, but we knew that we could take our intensity up at the same time. There's your half burpee. Good. Way to go right in. As soon as you hear the word mark, perfect. Curl, half burpee. Let's go. Now, if you're saying I can't do the half burpee, what do? Stay in the first 20-second move, which are just the curls. Two, one. 1 minute, 30 seconds, third round. Way to push. Really going to take that 1 minute and 30 seconds off. We're going to talk through what round three looks like. Round three merges all the moves with no rest in between. So what do you mean, DG? I'll show you. The 40 seconds stays the same. First 20 and then the second 20 looks the same. What are we eliminating from rounds one and two going into three? We're eliminating your 20 second rest between exercises. So you're going from dumbbell squats to the dumbbell squat jumps to the dumbbell swing to the lunge back. Then you're switching right over to the left and the opposite. There is no longer a 20 second rest in between exercises. Exercise one goes into two. Exercise two goes into three. Exercise three goes into four. Exercise five goes into six. Exercise seven goes into eight. And that's the end of round three. We got it? Yes or yes? No 20 second rest. All right, in just 10 seconds, we attack. Here we go, 5 seconds. We're setting up now so we can go on the go. Three, two, one. We've done this two other times, so we're well acquainted with where we got to go and what we got to do. Keep rocking. Keep rocking. And relax. All right, we're back at the top. I'm going to reset the timer so it can be 40 seconds. Here we go. Five, four, three, two, one, and start it over from the top. Here we go. All right, so now the rounds are set up right. We had 1 minute for round three, but we're going to stay with 40 seconds, okay? 40 seconds. Now, when you hear the word mark, you add the jump, or if you are physically challenged, you stay with the squat. At the end of move one, we're going straight into dumbbell swings. So you might as well just drop one weight and go right into your swing. At the end of that, three, two, one. We're live. It's a dumbbell swing. At the end of this 20 seconds, we add the step back lunge. Okay? You got it? At the end of that 20 seconds, we go right into the left arm swing with the right lunge step back. End of that round, we go straight into the dumbbell sit-up. There's your mark. Good job. Add the lunge. Let's get it.
Three, two, one.
Switch and go.
Go.
Switch and go. That's literally going to be your focus, is to switch and go. Nice wide shoulder width base on the feet. Give your body enough space to work with that weight. When you hear the word mark, you add the lunge back. When you add the lunge back, that's your mark. At the end of this round, you're going to drop straight to the ground. You have no time to waste, no time to rest. We're going straight to the ground for dumbbell sit-ups. When we get to the dumbbell sit-up, remember the second half is the in-out. Three, two, one. You're right to the dumbbell sit-up. At the end of the 20, You add the in and out with the legs. Let's go. Now, first 20 seconds, we're still working. We're at our max now. We're maxing out. We're leaving it all in the 20 seconds on the floor, especially on these sit-ups. You're getting that core straight. Now, you're adding the in out. At the end of this round, I'm coaching you into the next move. You got the single alternating dumbbell presses to the three pulses at the end of the 20 seconds. It's a lot of moving parts. That's why we set it up with demos, round three, one, round two.
Two,
one, we're one, up, single go. Arm shoulder presses. End of this 20 seconds, we add three pulses. We add three pulses. You got 3 seconds. You go straight to three pulses.
Mark.
From the bleachers, they screaming. All the ballers is bouncing. They like the way I be leaning. All the rappers be hating. Hope the track that I'm making. But all the hustles, they love it. Just to see one of them making. Came from the bottom.
You got 8 seconds. From here, you go straight to mountain climbers. Or they're called floor sprints. Go. At the mark, you go straight into plank jacks. 6 and 3. 3 and 6. Come on, run those legs. Let's go, let's go, let's go. We gotta run. We gotta run those legs. When you hear Mark, 3 plank jacks. There's Mark, 3 plank jacks. 6 climbers. 3 plank jacks. The next thing we do, we got dumbbell down ups. We add the jump. Remaining 20 seconds in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Dumbbell down ups. We got to go now. Go, 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 go. Good. Way to go right in. Way to find that dumbbell and go right in. Good. Now, at the halfway mark, you add the jump. That's what makes it. It adds intensity to the high intensity interval part. You already got 20 seconds of badass. And you add intensity to that move. Now you add the jump. Good. End of the 20 seconds, we switch over to the left arm. You keep the down up, you eliminate the jump. 10 more seconds remaining. 5 more seconds. You just switch and go. No stop.
Two,
you just switch
one,
and go.
Go.
Good. Let's get it. Now you got about 10 more seconds. You add that plyometric jump. If you can, if you have physical limitations, just keep the down up.
Mark.
Now your next move is a push-up to a walkout. First 20 seconds. I know I'm redundant, but I want to coach you through this. 20 seconds on just the push.
3, 2.
Then 20
one,
seconds on the walkout. If you're doing modified, make sure you're going chest, core, thighs. Chest, core, thighs should be hitting the ground. On a true modified, the legs should be swung up. 5 seconds, we add the walkout.
Mark.
And we walk it out. Good. Fingertips to the toes, we execute the jump. Now, your next move, curls to have burpees. That takes you through 3 rounds. You got just 5 seconds. Fight to get
three,
to your dumbbells now.
Two,
now.
One,
now.
Go.
Now. And go right into your curls. 20 seconds on the curls. At the halfway mark, we add the half burpee. Keep the dumbbells in your hands. It's way easier to just. All right.
Mark.
Halfway. Round 3. We isolate ourselves, barricade ourselves, backs against the wall. We fight to get out. 5 seconds remaining. 5. Come on, keep going, keep
three,
going, keep going. 10, 9, 8, 7. Come on, keep going. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Two,
round 4 starts
one,
now.
Go.
Dumbbell squats. First 20 seconds, we're live. Let's go. There's no rest between rounds 3 and 4. And in 4, there's no rest move to move. We go from move to move. Keep going, 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 and add your jump now. Let's go.
Mark.
Add that jump. 20 seconds. Now in 10 seconds, the entire round is the second 20 seconds.
Three,
so it's the raise and the lunge the whole time. Right and left. Let's go. Right raise, left lunge. We're doing the second half of the 20 seconds for the entire 40 seconds. Now, if you can't do the second half of the 40, do the first half of the 20.
Mark.
All right? Same arm. No switch. Hold time. Hold time. One arm. Same side. All 40 seconds. At the end of this move, we switch to the left arm.
Three,
with the right lunge,
two,
and it's for
one,
the entire
go.
40 seconds. Good. Now, when you hear the word mark, the word mark now only means to you, it's the halfway mark. You're not switching to the second half move because you're already there. Now, if you cannot maintain that, go back to the first half move with just the swing. You see what we did there? 15 more seconds. At the end of this round, at the end of this move, we go to the dumbbell sit-up to the in and out for the entire 40 seconds.
Three,
two, one. Go, 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 go. Dumbbell sit-up to the in out. Entire 40 seconds. Dumbbell sit-up in out. Are we coaching today? Are we getting better today? Are we getting better today? Come on. 20 seconds. Halfway means go harder. That means go harder. Come on, come on. Pick up your pace. That's what halfway means now. It means go harder. 10 seconds. Alternating dumbbell presses to three pulses. There's no just dumbbell press. We got press, press, pulse. Three, one, two, one, two, three, one, two, one, two, three. Whole 40 seconds. Second half move. DG, what do I do? If I can't do the second half part, what do? Do what we did and move. In the first 20. Next move. Climbers to jacks.
Three, two,
six climbers,
one,
three
go.
Plank jacks. Come on, you got six climbers, three plank jacks. Suck your navel into your spine. Drop your butt. Eliminate the TP. Come on, we're almost there. 20 seconds remaining. That's your halfway mark. We go into the down up with the jump for the whole 40 seconds. Right side only. Don't switch at the word mark. All you do is go harder. Let's go. It's the jump right on the top for 40 seconds. Do you got what it takes? Absolutely. Are there levels to this? Absolutely. Are you going to give your best? Absolutely not. Not all the time. But you do what you can do, while you can do what you can do. And then the more you get stronger, you increase more. Now that's your 20 second mark. That's your signal to go harder for your remaining 20 seconds. When you hear the word 3, 2, 1, it's gonna just switch you to the opposite side. 5 seconds remaining.
3, 2,
you switch and go. At the end of this round, we got the push up to the walkout. 40 seconds. You're gonna be so much better. You're gonna be so much better. You're gonna be so much better after you lock and load and you continue to believe in yourself, and you stop doubting yourself, and you start to say, you know what? I'm already beautiful inside and out at whatever size, at whatever waistline. But you know what? I feel a little bit better about myself because I set out to accomplish something. I said I was going to do the 7 p.m. I did it. I stayed steady for 6, 8 weeks, 10 weeks, 12 weeks, 8 months. And that's going to make you feel better. You're straight into the push-up and the walkout. If you've never had anybody believe in you, we're here. We're here. And we believe in you. As we're fighting for ourselves, we're fighting for you. 20 more seconds. Come on, this is the last round. Round four is it. Now, if I told you that round four would look like this, we would have been a little bit discouraged because we would have been apprehensive about how we're going to get into it. So what do? You just throw you into the fire. At the end of this round, you got curls and half burpees. And Shauna, I promise that is it. Joyce, I promise that is it. All right, 30 seconds remaining. It's just 40 seconds. And I say it just 40 seconds because this is it. No buyout. We're out. Yeah. 10 seconds to the cooldown. 5 more seconds. 5, 4,
3,
2,
1. Done.
All right. Great job. Great job.
Change is my time. Yeah, I'm new to the game, but y'all might wanna say you whack raps, stay late, save the time. I can dance, homie, I don't two step.
All right, great job. Feet together, go down, touch your toes.
I'm like a true player. A girl told me that a man that can dance might could possibly get down with
right side lunge. Great job, everybody.
Let me see it vibrate. And when it's over, you ain't gonna need your bow. Cause I'm a pro, make you bend your back low, then the pound of real bad to let the percolate.
Switch it up. Squat it down. Take your hands. Throw them to your heels. All right. Great job, everybody. If you're still on the live, man, and you made it through, post something so I can give you a shout out. Good job, Emily. Way to get through it. Renee, way to get through it. Marsha, way to get through it. Tawana, way to get through it. Christine, way to get through it. Ree, great way to get through it. Rachelle, great way to get through it. Way to get through it. Take that right arm across the chest. And if you're feeling like, man, I challenge myself, do it again. All right, not tonight, but do it again in the week, later in the week. Do it on the weekend. Great workout. Brenda, great job. Sandra, Brenda, great job. Way to work, ladies. Switch that arm up. Circle out those arms. Q, great job. Joyce, great job. Reverse those circles. Drop down to the ground, right knee into the chest, pull it as tight as you can get it in. Roll that knee over, back and forth, over the right side of your body to the left. And Renee, that's what it's about. It's about the end part. You not stopping, you giving all you got. All right. Switch that leg up, pull the left leg in, roll it over. Great job, Erica. I appreciate you supporting us, always shouting us out on Facebook as well. So we appreciate you. Great job, everybody. Andrea, good job. Pull both knees into the chest. Just like that. We promised you 45 minutes. We're at the 50-minute mark, 51-minute mark, and we're in the cool down. Kara, great job. Yeah, don't mess up your tiles. She said, I almost threw my weights. I forgot I have tiles. Yeah, don't mess up your house. Flip over onto your chest. Child's pose. Upward dog. One more child's pose. Upward dog. Flip back over to your back. Reach that right leg straight in the air. Pull it up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. Switch it up. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Pull both legs in. We appreciate you, Joyce. Thank you for that Cash App donation. Thank you for being our online live sponsor for tonight. I know you're on-demand subscriber, so I also appreciate your donation. Thank you so much. That keeps those live workouts coming. All right, we're up, and we're out of here just like that. We got in at 7. We're out of here by 8. The sun's still up. We're out of here. Great job, everybody. Team on 3. 1, 2, 3. Team, have a great evening, y'all. Great job. Way to push.